guys, welcome to Wrestling Figure Wednesday. Today, I will be reviewing the Mattel WWE Target exclusive Elite Hall of Fame series. As I said, you can only get this series at Target stores. This series, I believe, was not meant to come out until the spring of 2015, but it surfaced at the very end of 2014, right before Christmas. So, if you haven't seen this series at your Target yet, be sure to read the description of this video, as I provided the DPCI number, which is the number Target employees and their scanners use to look up this specific series in their system, and that way you could see if your store has it exactly or not. So good luck to you if you have not found it yet, and hopefully that little technique will help you locate it. That being said, let's take a look at the Elite Hall of Fame Sergeant Slaughter figure fresh in the packaging. As you can see, it says highly detailed action figure at the top. There's the Elite Collection logo, the new WWE logo, here's Sergeant Slaughter with all his accessories, and there's a cool LED Hall of Fame style background behind him, if you could see that. It says includes hat, whistle, and sunglasses. There's the WWE Hall of Fame logo, picture Slaughter, and there's a warning choking hazard because of all his small accessories there. It says class of 2004. And Sergeant Slaughter there. On this side, you could see the WWE Hall of Fame logo. It says class of 2004, Sergeant Slaughter. There's a picture of Slaughter there at the bottom. Looking at this side, there's a cool graphic of Slaughter, the WWE Hall of Fame logo, and it says 2004. And looking at the back of the box, there's a large image of Slaughter there. There's a WWE Hall of Fame logo. It says Sergeant Slaughter, ring attire, class of 2004. There's a small bio about him there. It says recreate the action of WWE. Also in the set is Stone Cold Steve Austin, Ultimate Warrior, and Trish Stratus. It says compete in these superstar rings. Pictured at the bottom is a Raw basic ring and SmackDown basic ring, and company information listed there at the bottom as well. So that being said, let's take a look at him fresh out of the packaging. Alright guys, so here we have the Mattel WWE Elite Hall of Fame exclusive to Target Sergeant Slaughter figure. Overall, I'd say it's a pretty awesome figure. I love that they finally made him in this outfit, as this is how I really remember him. I don't remember him in his Legends Series 1 outfit at all. So I was excited they made him like this, as this is his more popular attire. It is a really nice detailed figure. However, my complaint about this one, just like the Stone Cold one, is that I believe this is just a repaint of his old figure. So it has a very old joints, especially the leg joints that were frustrating. Where, I don't know if the pegs are too tight in the crotch area or what, but the legs don't stay in place like the old figures used to be, so that's frustrating. But the figure itself is pretty nice. Just so you know, Sergeant Slaughter is also one per case like Trish Stratus, so you might have a harder time finding him if you don't come across a fresh case of the set, so be sure to use that number I provided in the description to help you locate him. That being said, let's take a look at Slaughter up close. As you can see, here's Slaughter's head scan with all of his accessories on, and they are removable. You can see the detail in his hat. Pops off there, and you can see his awesome glasses, and you can see his combed over hair as well, which is pretty detailed and kind of funny. You can see all the detail there. The sunglasses do come off. You can see his mustache there, and his little angry face he's got going on. It's a ball jointed head that goes up and down as well as left and right. And he has his whistle accessory here. I don't know if the camera will pick it up. You can see the detail there. It's pretty nice. You could also remove that as well. Looking at his torso, his singlet is molded, so it feels like he's actually wearing it. You can see his camouflage shirt underneath. He has a typical Elite ab crunch joint. You can see all the detail on his back there as well. His ball-jointed arms that go up and down as well as outward. Swivel bicep joints, typical elbow joints. He has his black wrist tape. on both wrists. And the swivel wrist joint, the hand joint, that goes up and down. And he has an open hand here. Looking at his lower torso, he has a swivel waist joint, and he has his white belt. And they painted on the little buckle there, if you could see that. You can see the little belt loops they painted on as well. I see they messed up some of the paint there on mine, which is disappointing. So I'll have to clean that up a bit. Looking at his legs, he has ball-jointed legs that go up and down as well as outward. But this is where my complaint is. As you see, I want his leg to stay like this, but it just flings back. It won't even like keep the pose. So just be careful with the legs of it. And see, it's on both of them. It's really frustrating. So I wish Mattel just made him new legs or gave him new legs or something. But anyway, he has a swivel leg joint here, or thigh joint, I should say. And then he has his double-jointed knees, so you can pose him well. And then he has his really tall, greenish-colored boots, and you can see the detail in those with the laces and wrinkles. It's pretty cool. There's a swivel boot joint there, and then he has a black trim at the bottom as well. And then he has an ankle joint that I can't pose, because all the elite figures have the really stiff ankles, so just be careful. And he has that extra ankle joint as well. And yeah, that's Sergeant Slaughter. It is a cool figure. It has its flaws, unfortunately, but it is a really cool one, so if you're able to find him, good luck to you. It is a cool pickup. And yeah, thanks for watching. Be sure to like Wrestling Figure Wednesday on Facebook to suggest future reviews you'd like to see me do. And I'll see you next week. Thanks. For all your wrestling figure needs, check out ringsidecollectibles.com.
Like wrestling? Tune into The Rack, Thursday nights, 10 p.m. Eastern on wildtalkradio.com.
Crispy.